Well, Dick, we have invited some of your friends to join us to make some special presentations. So let's welcome back to Fox 8 the one and only Tim Taylor. Hi, Tim. Part of the team. We had Tim, Robin, Dick, and Casey.
After all these years.
Hi, Tim. Great to see you.
Why did you bring me?
After all these years, we're still friends. It was the greatest honor of my life to sit next to you for all those years. Almost 30 years.
Wow.
In the house that you built. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And it's my great honor also to read this proclamation. You'll excuse me if I have
to. It looks like the Gettysburg Address. What is
yes, it is. I'm not going to read all of it, Dick, if you don't mind.
I'll pick out
the highlights. Proclamation, Office of Mayor Frank G. Jackson, City of Cleveland, on behalf of the citizens of the City of Cleveland, I am honored to offer this proclamation in honor of Dick Goddard as he retires after a 55-year television career in Cleveland. Mr. Goddard is a Cleveland legend, both for his work as a meteorologist and as an animal activist. Mr. Goddard is a remarkable man whose work has truly made a difference in Cleveland. His many accomplishments are commendable, and his retirement is well deserved.
Is that it?
Those were some of the highlights.
Yes. Yeah. Well said, Mayor.
And well deserved.
Oh, mm-hmm. Nice. God bless you. I appreciate that. This is a wonderful little hangout, a place of honor amid the Woolly Bear plaques. And I can't thank people enough.
It's our honor to be here with
well,
you.
Well, thank you.
Well, you two have had many fantastic years together, and just watching you up in the conference room today, he was laughing so hard, just going back.
Most of the stories we can't tell.
We can't tell on the air, or the house that Goddard built would be turned into a garage. So we don't want to do that.
Remember Silver Tower City?
We don't want to say that. That happened. We're not done. We're not done yet. We've got to move along.
I haven't seen him laugh that hard in a long time.
It was a great session. Cool. We had a little soiree for Mr. Goddard today. Yeah. And now let's welcome another Cleveland legend here. John Telledge is here with another special presentation. And I sure wish either we were thinner, Tim, or the couch was wider.
No, that's
but
okay.
We'll figure something out. Can you?
Richard, this is from.
Yeah.
The governor of the state of Ohio. We all know Governor Kasich, and he has some great words for you and your great career here. How many whereases are there? There's about seven whereases. So we'll go through one real quickly for you. As Dick prepares for his well-deserved retirement, his legacy of compassion, tireless work ethic, and positive outlook will undoubtedly live on in the hearts and minds of the thousands of lives he has touched throughout his career. From the governor of the state of Ohio, John Kasich, and Mary Taylor, the lieutenant governor of Ohio.
Very nice, Richard.
You got a lot to hold there, too.
Thank you, JT. Hits just keep coming. We have more, don't we, Tracy and
Andre Bernier is going to come in now, and we have a special plaque and some other wonderful things, Richard, to pass along to you.
Wow, your hands are full.
Look at that. We've got two. The first one, Ed, many of you may already know that Dick served in the Air Force, and he served in one of my very favorite places in the world, Thule, Greenland. Or near Thule, Greenland. The Air Force would like to congratulate you on your retirement, recognize your public service to Cleveland.
Oh, wow, nice.
Dick, that's beautiful. Wow.
In addition to that, your retirement is also on the congressional record now, thanks to Representative Renacci.
Yeah, he was here earlier.
Mm-hmm. Yes, he was. Nice.
Jim, good man.
And you still wear your Air Force jacket.
Yeah,
it still fits.
I was on our side,
Oh, that is just wonderful. Well, Dick, we have one final presentation from your family on the other side of the clock, and this is a big one.
Here now, the anchors from Fox 8 News in the Morning, Wayne Dawson, Stephanie Schaefer, Christy Cable, Todd Meany with a major, major announcement.
Dick, we could not be more proud to work right here alongside you at Fox 8.
And all of us are honored to be the ones to make a very special presentation to you today.
So Fox 8 has contacted the folks at Guinness World Records, and they have officially verified you as having the longest career of a weather forecaster of anyone in the world.
Wow. A copy of this certificate will hang in the newly named Dick Goddard Weather Center in our newsroom. We also have one for you to keep as well to show the pets.
So, Dick, from your friends here at Fox 8 News in the Morning,
congratulations.
And I have that in my hand, yeah.
Guinness. Wow.
We're looking at it right now, the certificate, the longest career as a weather forecaster, Dick Goddard, in Cleveland, Ohio, USA, from September of 1965 to 2016. Officially amazing, and that's on the certificate. How about that?
I could use a Guinness right now.
We were smart.
You're going to have to wait a while.
Yeah. Thank you, Dick.
We are going to keep everyone seated right here. We're going to talk with Tim and Dick's final forecast just moments away.
I can't wait to see what I'm going to say.
Well, you've dedicated your entire life to the Four Foots, and we're happy with this foundation to do even more.
Well, I want to keep doing it, and the station is going to let me do it, too.
Absolutely. We'll talk more about that. But first, what you also do very well is the weather. Nobody does it better than this guy. We have estimated that you have done more than 100,000 weather forecasts. Is that unbelievable? So we have one more for you right now.
Well, take it away.
Take it away.
For the next 3 months, it's going to be cold. It's going to snow from time to time. What's that?
Don't go out on a limb, Dick.
I do that almost every night, but bless your hearts. Thank you so much.
There's the 8-day forecast. All right, Tim, final thought from you.
You know, I just want to say that Dick has always told all of us that in this business, we're all just penciled in. But I always said to Dick, that's true for us, but not so much for you. His name, Dick, your name is indelibly printed in the halls of Cleveland lore. Television lore, weather lore.
Make it good.
Really is.
Well,
God bless you.
I can't tell you how much I want to thank everybody who's kept me on the air. And Andre and the whole gang and AJ and Scott Sable. We have a great weather team.
You do.
And Jan Harsh as well.
Dick, were you, when you were on the 10 o'clock news with Tracy and myself, we would always end the show. People would get mad at me
what would you
sometimes.
Say?
I would always say goodnight, Dick.
Goodnight, Dick.
And let me just say
that pretty well.
One other thing here. Normally, when we do the newscast, not too many people in the studio. There's really a cast of thousands in this studio with us right now. And so many tears out there as well, because that's what this guy, Dick Goddard, means to all of us in this TV station. Very special man. And maybe you have something you'd like to say to all the co-workers who love you so much.
Well, you two will be given a stray dog or cat.
Tonight.
You want to hurt your feelings, right? Thank you so much.
You know what, Tim said it well. I mean, this is your house, the house that you built, and this will always be your home, and we will always be your family.
I hope so.
What a legacy.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dick, for everything.
Yeah, Dick got it. You know what, Dick? We don't want to ever cut you short. We have a couple of more minutes. Any more final thoughts, anything else you'd like to say?
Well, again, I'd be good to the animals, the Four Foots, and the two-footed animals, too.
Right.
But I don't handle this very well. I'm sorry. My voice is now.
Dick, it sounds very much like it did on your first broadcast, right?
It was higher. Yeah.
Dick said his voice was so high back 1961, right?
Small animals gathered outside the station.
Right. That's how high his voice was.
We are not quite done yet. Finally tonight, I want to invite your Fox 8 colleagues, family, and friends to come on in. Let's take a look right now, a final look back at your career, set to the music of your favorite artist, Bob Seger.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thank you, Dick.
Here it is.
Silver bullet,
ever going back.
Against the wind. We were running against the wind. We were young and strong, we were running against the wind. We're
What to leave in, what to leave out. Against the wind, I'm still running against the wind.
No. Thank you, Dick.
Thank you.
A wonderful
we
life
love
and
you.
Great memories.
Thank you.
And we do love you.
Good night.
Fox 8 News at 7:00.